Hello, I'm Chloe.
And I'm Aiden.
And this is Headline News. Marco Rubio takes a blow by losing to his home state, Florida. Being humiliated from losing to Trump and Clinton, he drops out of the race, losing his hopes to become the President of the United States. Clinton has won Florida and North Carolina and completely threw down Sanders by taking Ohio and Illinois. Kasich has kept his home state and Trump took the vote for Florida. So far, Trump and Hillary will be the last ones standing.
France and Belgian police had launched a manhunt for a man suspected in November's Paris terror attacks. The name of this man is Lazam Lachouli. He has recently been arrested. When they found his safe house, they worked quickly to surround it. After trying to run, he was shot in the leg just after running a few feet from the door.
And on a depressing note, a gunfight in Indiana led to one wounded and one killed police officer. Deputy Carl Coons and Sergeant Jordan Buckley were shot out while serving a warrant on Sunday at 12:30. Deputy Coons was shot and killed. His partner, Sergeant Buckley, was also shot but only injured. His family was devastated. Many officers have been killed in the past weeks because some people are too cowardly to cooperate with law enforcement. I'm Chloe.
And I'm Aiden.
And now to local news.
Hi, my name is Noah.
Hello, my name is Taylor.
Hello, my name is Hector.
And we're the local news. One man was killed and two other innocent people were injured in a shooting incident Wednesday morning. The police first knew on 10 a.m. Wednesday morning. A woman turned up at CHI Health Emmanuel for treatment. That led police to 46th and Kansas, where two other victims were located. The crime scene is wrapped in yellow tape. One of the people were brought into a police cruiser and held for questioning.
In other news, the Norfolk Daily News reports that this boy was sentenced Tuesday and given a similar sentence for torturing a cat in an animal shelter. A year of probation, 50 hours of community service, and more counseling and mental health evaluation for torturing a cat and vicious other animals in an animal shelter.
A 19-year-old girl got bit by a pit bull and is still alive. She was driven 2 hours from her house in Hastings. It was her neighbor's dog, and it bit her in the face Friday night. She doesn't pay attention to her face, but she still plays outside.
That's it for the local news.
Hi, my name is Adriana.
My name is Linda.
And I'm Brian, and this is this week's weather.
Monday is going to be high 67 and low 37 with 0% chance of rain. Tuesday is going to be 71 and low 42 with 20% chance of rain.
Wednesday is going to be high 71, low 42 with 20% chance of rain.
Thursday's weather is going to be high 61, low 41 with 20% chance of rain. Friday's weather is going to be high 65, low 46 with 10% chance of rain.
Bad weather for many days began a blitz on South Wednesday night. There was a flooding in Mississippi. Damage was left in the town of Purvis. There was flooding in many western towns of Mississippi because of a very bad weather. Large hail came down on southwest part of the state. Bad weather for many days began a blitz on the south Wednesday night. A spinning tornado in Oklahoma injured at least 7 people. And this is the weather story for today.
My name is Zachary, and this is
Isaiah, and also here is
Dalton, and here is Tyler,
and we are here with Wilson Sports. Adam Lancroft walked into the White Sox clubhouse many times over the last year with his son. Lancroft now likely will walk away from baseball because of the club's decision that he limit his son's clubhouse presence. Lancroft, 36, announced his plans to leave the Sox and lose the $13 million left on his contract for this season. The news caused a conversation about children in sports locker rooms, as well as how much is too much when it comes to taking your children to work.
Monday, March 21st, March Madness continued. Kansas played Austin, and the score was Kansas 105, Austin 79. Next was Next was Kentucky played Indiana, and the score was Indiana 73 and Kentucky 67. Next was Kansas played Villanova. The score was Villanova 64 and Kansas 59. UNC played Notre Dame, and the score was UNC 88, Notre Dame 74. And now as we continue, we end up in the Final Four.
Monday night's home defeat to Atlanta was the fourth straight for Chicago. They're not used to such a losing streak in the Windy City. The Bulls will try to avoid a game streak on Tuesday night when they visit the Pacers.
And that's it for the Wilson Sports.
Hi, I'm Connor, and this is Sports of the Week. Husker baseball defeats Wichita State 7-3. Freshman Matt Waldron improved to 3-1 on the year and went a season high of 6-23 innings for the second straight weekend. Creighton Blue Jays completed its fourth consecutive weekend sweep by taking both games into a doubleheader with North Dakota State on Sunday, March 20th. The Blue Jays posted a 5-0 win in seven innings in the opener and then claimed the sweep with a 7-1 win in the series final. I'm Connor, and that's all for Sports of the Weeks.
Hello, Wilson. I'm Eric.
I'm Noah.
And I'm Sam.
And we're here for the Wilson Lunch of the Week.
For Monday, we're having beef pizza, fish sandwich with green beans and veggie relish.
On Tuesday, we're having burrito, cheese sauce, corn dog with Mexican rice and peaches.
On Wednesday, we're having spicy chicken, sloppy joe with carrots and pears on.
On Thursday, we're having cheeseburger, bratwurst with bun with juice and nacho chips.
On Friday, we're having Fiestada baked potato bar with broccoli and mandarin oranges.
This is the food fact for the week.
Pumpkin pie was first introduced to the dinner table on the second Thanksgiving in 1623.
That's the history of the pumpkin pie. Boston cream pie is a cake, not a pie.
Hi, I'm Chloe.
And I'm Sydney.
And we're here for what's on TV. On Monday, on AMC, Twister at 7 p.m. On ESPN, Cavaliers and Hawks at 7 p.m. On FX, Grown Ups 2 at 7 p.m.
On Tuesday, on HBO, Pitch Perfect 2 at 5, College Slam Dunk and 3-Point Championships from Kai Press, Texas at 4, and Figure Skating World Championships at 8.
On Wednesday, on AMC, A New Walking Dead at 8 p.m. On ESPN 2, the NCAA's Women's Basketball Tournament Final Four at 7:30 p.m. on FXX Pompeii at 7 p.m.
On Thursday on ESPN, the Dodgers at the Padres at 6:05. On TNT, Iron Man 2 at 5:20. On FXM, Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs 2 at 6:30.
And on Friday, on AMC, Jurassic Park at 7 and FX Marvel's Avengers at 6. I'm Chloe.
And I'm Sydney.
And we'll see you next week for what's more on TV.
I'm Krista.
I'm Julia.
I'm Maddie.
We're here with the Wilson Buzz Netflix reviews. Starting with Grey's Anatomy is a show that has been on since 2005 and is now in its 12th season. In season one, we are introduced to Meredith Grey, the star of the show, who is starting her surgical internship at Seattle Grace Hospital. The show is full of drama, romance, and comedy. There are many great couples on the show, Meredith and Derek, April and Jackson, and Callie in Arizona, and many more couples that you will fall in love with. One of the most explosive episodes of Grey's Anatomy is season 2, episode 18, when a man is admitted to the ER because he was shot with a grenade gun. Without knowing this, an EMT uses her hand to stop the bleeding. The doctors soon find out that the grenade never exploded. The whole building goes on lockdown, but Meredith stays with the girl and the bomb techs. When the paramedic is scared, she takes her hand off the bomb, and in an effort to save the lives of everyone in the room, Meredith sticks her hand in the body cavity to hold the bomb steady. To find out what happens, go check out Grey's Anatomy on Netflix. The show has many more twists and turns that can make you want to throw the remote at the TV, but don't do that because TVs can be really expensive.
Next is Supernatural. It is a show that has been around since 2005. It is on its 12th season. In the first season, we were introduced to Sam and Dean Winchester, who had gone on their separate ways until their dad does something, and they look for him. They go on a trip, and in the process, they face all kinds of evil spirits, and they're looking for their dad. They face problems with each other and the people from their past.
Last is Fuller House. Fuller House is about the Tanner family who returns to their old house and face problems ahead. you run into some old characters from Full House. They face older problems and newer ones. DJ Tanner is learning how to accept the fact that she has grown up and she's facing the problem where she has to support her three boys. When her sister Stephanie shows up to help, DJ's world is saved, along with the help of Kimmy, DJ's old best friend.
That's it for the Wilson Buzz Netflix reviews.
I'm Michael.
I'm Jason.
And I'm Jaden.
And we are doing the top 10 music of the week.
Sitting at number one is Work by Rihanna featuring Drake.
Up next is 7 Years by Lucas Graham.
At number three is Love Yourself by Justin Bieber.
And at number four is My House by Flo Rida.
At number five is Stressed Out by 21 Pilots.
At number six is No by Megan Trainor.
And at number seven is Me, Myself, and I by G, Easy, and X Baby.
At number eight is Pillow Talk by Zayn.
At number nine is Cake by the Ocean by DNCE.
And that, at last but not least, is number 10, I Took a Pill in Ibiza by Michael Posner.
That's it for the top 10 songs of the week.
Hi, I'm Sydney.
I'm Jamie.
And I'm Angel.
And we're here to tell you the actress of the week.
Zoe Kravitz is an American actress. You may know her from the Divergent series as Christina. She first appeared in the films No Reservation and The Brave One. She also played Angel Salvador in the Marvel comic superhero film X-Men First Class. Zoe has modeled in fashion magazines such as French Jealous, Venice Zine, and Ellie. Zoe began making music at the age of 16. She formed in the New York, Philadelphia-based band Elevator Fight, which she performed in 2009.
Kate Beckinsale was born July 26, 1973. She is also an American actress. You may know her from the Underworld series as Celine. She also has played in the movie Clicked. After some minor television roles, Kate has worked occasionally as a model. In 1997, she appeared in the music video for George Michael's waltz, Away Dreaming. While she was a student, she was in a British dramas like Prince Julian in 1994, also appeared in Cold Comfort Farm. Her most popular movie is Total Recall. That movie made $200 million. She is most known for playing in the Underworld's Awakening, Underworld of Evolution, Underworld Rise of the Lycans.
Gal Gadot was born and raised in Israel. Gal Gadot is an American actress and a fashion model. You may know her from Wonder Woman. In her life when she was younger, Gal wanted to be a lawyer. However, at the age of 18, she attended and won the 2004 Miss Israel. 28 September 2008, Gadot married her boyfriend, and with that 2 years, she was in the films in 2009, The First Fast and Furious, and Gal Gadot is a wonderful actress, and make sure you see her in the movie Batman vs. Superman.
And that's all for the Actress of the Week.
Hi, my name is Tay-Tay Thales.
Hi, my name is Brooke.
Hi, my name is Lexi.
And we're here for Celebrity of the Week. The Celebrity of the Week is Drake.
Drake is a well-known rapper and records through OVO Sound.
Drake's real name is Aubrey Drake Graham.
Drake started as an actor in the 2001-2005 Degrassi.
In the show Degrassi, Drake was a basketball star but then was shot by a classmate.
Not long after Degrassi, Drake dropped an album called So Far Gone, but wanted to make more.
Drake's birthday is October 24th and was 29 years old.
With Drake, stands from Toronto and he was born in October. OVO stands for October's Very Own.
Drake has gone on tour and been guest at many concerts such as J. Cole's show 2014 Forest Hill Tribe.
Drake currently is single and is not seeing anybody, but low-key has a thing for Nicki Minaj.
In 2010 and 2011, Drake dropped another album called Thank Me Later, but Drake's most recent song in 2016 is Summer 16.
Drake has been very successful in his rap career.
Drake mainly works with The Weeknd, Big Sean, and other big rappers.
Drake has his own online store where you can buy merch. The prices range from $15 all the way to $320. One jacket was over $300. That jacket was not that cute.
Drake is very known to be seen at NBA games.
Well, I'm Taylor Fallis.
I'm Brooke.
And I'm Lexi.
And that's it for Celebrity of the Week. See you next time.
I'm Lucy.
And I'm Sean. And we're here with the top music artist of the week.
Abel Tesfaye, or better known as The Weeknd, was born February 16, 1990 in Scarborough, Toronto, Canada.
His dad walked out on his family, so his grandma raised him because his mom worked a lot. When he was 17, he got kicked out of his high school and transferred to a different school, but he dropped out after 6 months of being there. He made his best friend Lamar Taylor drop out with him.
He lived in Canada his whole life. His first time on a plane was his first tour a couple of years ago. His first album was Trilogy. It's a collection of his three mixtapes.
The Weeknd has made a big impact on music. A lot of other artists compliment him on his work. There's artists that want to work with him. Kendrick Lamar says that he would love to work with him.
And that's it for Featured Artist of the Week.
My name is Julia.
My name is Hannah.
And today we're talking about Athlete of the Week.
Athlete of the Week is Luke Kinder. He goes to Carnegie High School in Oklahoma.
He's in football, baseball, and runs track. He made 27 touchdowns in football.
He could win up to 4,000 scholarships.
He suffered a collapsed lung during his junior season and came back his senior year.
On the field, Luke Kinder has a 3.7 GPA, also has been a vice president for all 4 years of school. He is an Olympic coach.
Thanks for watching Athlete of the Week.
Hi, my name is Cameron.
Hi, my name is Gabby, and this is the book reviews of the week.
Stanley Yelnats is under a curse that began with his no-good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather and has since followed generations of Yelnats. Now Stanley has been unjustly and does not know that he is basically the camp slave just like everyone else.
The book backlash is about a girl named Laura who is told she is fat and ugly and is bullied both in school and online. And the boy Christian that she had liked started it all. One day she goes into her bathroom and overdoses on pills and tries to commit suicide. Her parents said that she had tried to hurt herself before, but not this bad.
And that's it for the book reviews of the week.
What's up, Winston?
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Kaden.
And we're doing Courage the Cowardly Dog. Courage the Cowardly Dog originally premiered as a short on February 18, 1996. The show premiered on November 12, 1999, and became the highest-rated premiere in Cartoon Network history at the time. It last aired on November 22, 2002, with 50 episodes produced in 4 seasons.
John R. made Courage the Cowardly Dog.
They made the old man dislike the dog and wanted to throw him out the window, but the old lady wanted him to.
You can watch Critch the Cowardly Dog on Netflix or YouTube.
This is the end of Cartoon Character News.
Hello, my name is Amir.
Hello, my name is Emma.
And my name is Abraham.
And welcome to the app of the week.
The app of the week is Nike.
The founder of Nike is Bill Warman and Phil Knight.
Nike is an app that you can use to shop on the Nike store instead of going online.
What do you use the Nike app for?
Well, I use the Nike app because you can shop for shoes and look for clothing.
I think it's probably my favorite app.
I also think it's my favorite app, too.
I think it's cool because you can design your own shoe.
I love looking and designing the shoes on there, too.
Well, that's the app of the week.
Hello, I'm Ashton.
Hi, I'm Alex.
And welcome to Comic News. So first on the list is the new Batman vs. Superman movie starring Ben Affleck, who plays as Batman, Henry Cavill, who plays Superman, and Gal Gadot, who plays as Wonder Woman.
I can't wait. So this movie is about Superman fighting Batman because Batman thinks Superman's an evil alien that's going to destroy them all. Of course, this is before the Justice League Part 1 movie. This is also the first appearance of Wonder Woman in the cinematic universe of DC.
Wow, really? That's so Raven. I'm Ashton.
And I'm Alex. And that's all for today with Comic News.
Hi, my name is Alfonso.
And my name is Sam.
Today we will be bringing you the technology news of the week.
We will be focusing on Samsung, founded by Lee Byung-chul.
Samsung started out as a small trading company in South Korea.
In 1947, the owner of Samsung invested in a new company called Samsung Wolseong Gongsa.
In the late 1960s, Samsung joined the electronic industry. The first product from Samsung was black and white TVs.
In 1980, Samsung entered telecommunications. The earliest project was a switchboard, which is used to interconnect telephones.
The 1990s were a major turning point for Samsung. They began to rise as an international corporation in 2000. Samsung opened a computer programming laboratory in Poland.
In 2011, Samsung sold its hard disk drive to a business to Seagate. Unfortunately for Samsung, many people in New Zealand began to report many of Samsung washing machines spontaneously catching on fire.
That sounds very scary.
Yeah, I guess so, but it would be a cool story to tell your friends that your washing machine caught on fire.
In 2012-2015 was a bunch of investments into the company and many others.
This year, Samsung announced that they will be working with Microsoft IoT devices based on Windows 10.
This has been the Technology of the Week.
Bye, Wilson.
Hi, my name is Gavin.
And my name is Robert.
And we are doing the video game news.
The first top five games are The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD and has a view of 300...
Also, Far Cry Primal for PS4 and Call of Duty Black Ops 3 is in the top 5 games too.
Finally, in 5th place is the Gundam Breaker 3.
We're also going to talk about the Oculus Rift.
Yes, it is so cool. It is like you're in the game. It is like you're doing the whole thing.
Also, the Rift is very pricey. Top requiring is a very powerful P3.
Have a great day, Wilson.
Hi, I'm Bella.
Hi, I'm Brenda.
And we're doing the holiday of the week. On April 4th is Vitamin C Day. Load up on citrus fruit, berries, and green vegetables for Vitamin C Day. On April 5th is Caramel Day. Caramel Day is dedicated to the rich, gooey, delicious substance made with the dark alchemy of the culinary arts.
April 6th is a day of hope.
April 8th is Name Yourself Day. Everyone needs a change of pace now and then, and sometimes we just don't feel like ourselves. This day is dedicated to the ultimate form of self-expression. It's Name Yourself Day. I'm Bella.
I'm Brenda.
And that's it for Holiday of the Week.
Hi, I'm Shelby.
And I'm Rachel.
We're here with the Did You Know Facts of the Week.
Did you know that an ostrich's eye is bigger than its brain?
Wow, that's really cool. Did you know the sentence, the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog, uses every letter in the English alphabet?
Did you know that a crocodile can't move its tongue?
Now that's snappy.
Get it? Because crocodiles snap.
Yeah, it's cool, but did you know grapes explode when you put them in the microwave?
Now that's what I call a very cool fact.
Rachel, that's so dumb. Where did you even find that pun? On Google?
Yeah, Google is like the most used search engine there is.
Did you know that the smaller dogs actually live longer than larger dogs?
Awesome. Did you know that a dentist created the electric chair?
Alrighty then.
And that's all for the Did You Know Facts of the Week.
Hola, mi nombre es Hazel. Hoy les hablaré sobre las pupusas. Las pupusas son el platillo típico de El Salvador. Las pupusas están hechas de masa de maíz y se rellenan de diferentes ingredientes. Una de las más famosas es la pupusa revuelta, rellena de una mezcla de carne, de cerdo, frijoles y queso. También hay otras muy populares como las pupusas de ayote con queso. Las pupusas no tan y otras no tan comunes como las pupusas de pollo o de pescado. Las pupusas también pueden hacerse de harina de arroz. Los salvadoreños comemos pupusas a cualquier hora del día, en especial durante los fines de semana para compartir tiempo con la familia. Esto es todo por hoy. Hasta la próxima.
Hola, mi nombre es Cristian.
Hello, my name is Miguel, and welcome to the top videos of the week. And these upcoming videos are not chosen over views, but over how funny they were. My friend Christian will review a video in Spanish for the non-English speaking students in Wilson.
Entre un momento vamos a hablar de este video con mi amigo Miguel. Primero, Miguel va a hablar de este video en inglés y después yo voy a hablar de este video en español para los estudiantes que no pueden hablar inglés.
So let's get into this first one here. And trust me, you don't want to see this if you're terrified of baby deer. Not like there would be a person that is. Sounds pretty innocent, right? But then he found out that his brother Bambi took the last scoop of Nutella. Now let me say one more thing before I pass it on to my friend Christian. If I saw that this happened, I would be warning the town, not laughing.
Ahora yo hablaré del video que escogí para la semana. El video se trata de un puerco que sale de su jaula y está destruyendo la ciudad. Gracias por mirar el video con mi amigo Miguel.
Thanks for watching the videos we chose. Hopefully you enjoyed them just as much as we did.
Officer Height for your safety tip of the week.
Hi everyone, this is Officer Height and I'm back with another weekly installment of Officer Height Safety Tips. And what I want to talk about today isn't so much a safety tip as it is a good trend to follow, and that's, you know, talking about bullying in our schools. It's been a while since I've spoke about bullying in Wilson Middle School, and over the last few weeks we've had a few issues with it, and that word's been brought up quite often to Officer Height. Remember, if you are a Wilson student and you see somebody bullying somebody, make sure you contact an adult, let a teacher know, contact myself, contact an administrator, let them know what's going on. But definitely let an adult know in the building that you're seeing bullying going on. Also, it's okay to stick up for that person. If you see somebody getting bullied, stick up for them. But like I said, the main thing is to make sure that you you let an adult know, either that, you know, a staff member, a teacher, Officer Height, or one of the administrators, also one of the counselors. So Wilson Middle School is a bully-free zone, and we do not allow it. We do not condone it. We absolutely want to rid our school of that evil thing. So make sure if you see somebody being bullied that you let somebody know what's going on. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Chelsea.
I'm Leah.
And I'm Emily, and this is the quote of the week.
Life is not about waiting for the storm to pass, but learning to dance in the rain. I picked this quote because when I was depressed about something that was going on in my life, I realized that even though what I was going through was bad, I could still find a way to make things better.
The only real failure in life is the failure to try. This quote is saying that if you don't try, you're not getting anywhere in life. I picked this quote because when I took a test, I wasn't trying hard enough, and I realized that if I wasn't going to succeed in life.
Don't waste your life to impress other people. Do what you love and love what you do. This quote means that instead of doing what the popular people do, be yourself instead of what people want you to be. I picked this quote because I try to impress people and I don't have to. I just have to do what I love.
I'm Chelsea.
I'm Aaliyah.
And I'm Emily.
And that's it for Quotes of the Week.
Hello, my name is Sasani.
And I'm Nevaeh, and this is Jokes of the Week.
What do you call old snowman?
I don't know. What do you call an old snowman?
Water. Well, then you try.
Your mom is so fat, she couldn't identify a picture of her feet.
Oh, yeah, your mom is so ugly, she couldn't get a date on a calendar. What? Here, how about this one? How does Lady Gaga make her clothes?
I don't know. How does she make her clothes?
Cover herself in glue and roll in random objects.
Did you hear about the kidnapping at school?
Oh, who was it?
It's okay, he woke up.
And now here's part two of Jokes of the Week.
Hello, I'm Nevaeh.
And I'm Keaton.
And this is even more Jokes of the Week. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Beats.
Beats who?
Beats me. A man arrived in a small town on Friday. He stayed for 2 days and left on Friday.
How is this possible?
His horse name is Friday.
Ha ha ha, you got me. You want to hear a story about Mr. Detman?
Sure, I don't see why not.
Okay, so he is asking his students questions. Then he asks, kids, what does the chicken give you? The students answer, meat. Then he replies, very good. Now what does the pig give you? The students answer, bacon. Then he replies, great. Now what does the fat cow give you? And the class answers, homework.
Don't talk about Mr. Detman like that. That's just rude.
Oops.
Every year on my birthday, I look forward to my aunt's gift, a scarf, hat, or a knitted sweater by hand. One year, she must have had better things to do because I received a ball of yarn, knitting needles, and a how-to knit book. Her card read, scarf, some assembly required.
Wow, that's crazy. Oh, my boyfriend wrote this amazing poem about me.
Really? Let me hear it.
Okay. Roses are red, your blood is too. You look like a monkey and belong in a zoo. Do not worry, I'll be there too. Not in a cage, but laughing at you.
Oh, that shows how much he cares. He thinks you belong in a zoo. Isn't that sweet?
Yeah.
Whenever your ex says, you'll never find someone like me, the answer to that is, that's the point.
You must have been born on a highway because that's where most accidents happen.
Two wrongs don't make a right. Take your parents as an example. I'm Nevaeh.
And I'm Keaton.
And that's it for this episode of Jokes of the Week. Bye.
That's it for the Wilson Buzz.
See you next week.